Welcome to the longest running quiz show in the area. Categories. High school students compete to answer questions on topics from art to science, history to current events. And now, here's your categories host, John Bartel.
Hi, welcome to Categories. Today we're bringing you a great matchup from two schools from the Blue Valley School District as Blue Valley Northwest, the Huskies, coached by Rob Meacham, take on the Blue Valley West Jaguars, coached by Dana Onneman. Let's go ahead and meet our contestants first from Northwest.
I'm Ben, I'm a junior.
I'm Alex, I'm a junior.
I'm Addison, and I'm a junior.
I'm Ariana, I'm a junior.
I'm Arvin, and I'm a sophomore.
And our contestants from West.
Hi, I'm Hamant Kandurthy, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Dante, and I'm a senior.
I'm Neha, and I'm a junior.
I'm Srivitz, and I'm a junior.
And I'm True, and I'm a junior.
All right, here on Categories, in the first round, we will take turns answering questions. If the team responds correctly, they earn a point for their squad. If they answer incorrectly, the other team will get a chance to steal that category. We did a coin toss before we started taping. It was won by the Huskies of Northwest, so here is the first category for you. It is general knowledge. What was the name of the short, boyish haircut worn by women in the 1920s? Ariana?
Pixie cut.
I'm sorry, cannot take pixie cut. Jaguars, chance to steal this general knowledge question. What was the name of the short, boyish haircut worn by women in the 1920s? Amant?
The bob.
It's the bob. Staying with you, West, sorry. Current events is the category. On January 27th, Theresa May became the first world leader to meet with President Trump. What is the current position that May holds? Srivitz?
Prime Minister.
Prime Minister, very good. Coming back to you, Huskies. U.S. history is the category. What state provided more soldiers, supplies, and money to the Union war effort than any other? Addison.
Pennsylvania.
It is not Pennsylvania. Jaguars, chance to steal this U.S. history question. What state provided more soldiers, supply, and money to the Union war effort than any other? New York. Jaguars, staying with you, fine arts is the category. Peter Paul Rubin and Anthony Van Dyck helped make what city the center of the Flemish School of Painting? Armand?
Amsterdam.
I'm sorry, it is not Amsterdam. Huskies, chance to steal this fine arts question. Peter Paul Rubin and Anthony Van Dyck helped make what city the center of the Flemish School of Painting? Arvin.
Florence.
It is not Florence, it's Antwerp. Antwerp. Northwest, staying with you, geometry is the next category. A trapezoid has only one pair of parallel sides. What are they called? Ben?
Bases.
They're bases, very good. Coming back to you, West, sports is the category. Name the winter Olympic event in which a two-runner sled carries a rider down an 80-meter ice track at speeds of up to 60 miles per hour. Hamant?
Luge.
Luge, very good. We would have taken skeleton also. Huskies, U.S. geography is the category. Name the only U.S. state whose boundaries have no straight lines. Ben?
Hawaii.
It is Hawaii. Coming back to you, Jaguars, you too have a U.S. geography question, this time dealing with population. What is the most heavily populated county in the United States? Time. We're going to try Northwest here, trying to stay in the category of U.S. geography population. Arvin, it is Los Angeles. You are correct. Huskies, we are staying with you. Sports is the category. What two positions in baseball use a substantially different glove from the other seven? Alex.
First base and catcher.
First base and catcher are the two. Very good. Jaguars, coming back to you. This time you have a science health category question. What five-syllable adjective is given to diseases that are caused by germs and spread from objects or people to other people? Huskies, chance to steal this science and health question. What five-syllable adjective is given to diseases that are caused by germs and spread from objects or people to other people? Ariana?
Immunopathic.
Cannot accept that. Communicable is what we were looking for, communicable. Huskies, we are staying with you. Your category is U.S. government. What cabinet department manages the Coast Guard? Ben?
The Department of Defense.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. Jaguars, chance to steal this U.S. government category. What cabinet department manages the Coast Guard? Time on that. Transportation. West, you do get the next question. It is religion as far as the category. What Indian religion's symbol consists of two curved swords and a double-edged dagger? Srivitz?
Sikhism,
very good. Huskies, coming back to you, fine arts, specifically theater. Hal Prince and Stephen Sondheim made a hit musical out of what old English ballad about a crazed London barber? Alex?
Sweeney Todd.
It is Sweeney Todd. Back to you, West. Literature is the category. This novel describes life in the Yukon during the Great Gold Rush of 1896, and the author is Jack London. Time on that. Coming over to you, Huskies. Chance to steal this literature category. This novel describes life in the Yukon during the Great Gold Rush of 1896. Ben.
The Call of the Wild.
It is The Call of the Wild. Northwest, staying with you. Vocabulary is the category. Give me the adjective that means cat-like. Ben.
Feline.
Very good. Coming back to you, West. Vocabulary again is the category. Name an eight-letter word that describes the largest landmass in the world. Srivitz?
Antarctica.
Cannot accept Antarctica. Huskies, chance to steal this vocabulary question. Alex?
Eurasia.
Very good. Northwest, coming back to you with a literature question. From Alice in Wonderland, what creation of English literature, this is the description, came whiffling through the Tovey Woods? Ben?
The Hare.
It is not The Hare. Jaguars, chance to steal this literature category from Alice in Wonderland. What creation of Dante?
The Jabberwocky.
It is The Jabberwocky. Jaguars, staying with you, U.S. government is the category. What three words complete this passage from the U.S. Constitution? And I'll start the quote now. Treason against the United States shall consist only in levying war against them or in adhering to the enemies, giving them what and what? Time on that. Chance to steal, Huskies. U.S. government is the category. What three words complete this passage from the U.S. Constitution? Treason against the United States shall consist only in levying war against them or in adhering to the enemies, giving them what and what? Aid and comfort. Huskies, staying with you, current events is the category. Mexican drug lord Joaquin Guzman was extradited to the U.S., where he pleaded not guilty to charges against him in a Brooklyn court. What is the famous nickname? Arvin?
El Chapo.
It is El Chapo. West, coming back to you, mathematics is the category. I will read the question twice. Find the number that logically completes this series. 2, 3, 5, 9, 17, blank. I'll read it again. Find the number that logically completes this series. 2, 3, 5, 9, 17, blank. Shrevitz?
33.
It is 33. Huskies, coming back to you. Science, biology is the category. What is the name given to the boundary of cells in animals? Alex?
Cell wall.
Cannot accept that. Jaguars, chance to steal this science biology question. What is the name given to the boundary of cells in animals? Neha?
Cell membrane.
It's the cell membrane. Very good. Jaguars, staying with you. It's general knowledge. This time, general knowledge of food. What is the name for a dip made from mashed avocado, chopped onions, and tomatoes, lime juice? Neha.
Guacamole.
It is guacamole. I had guacamole last night. Absolutely delicious. All right. Northwest, coming back to you. Philosophy is the category. What Greek philosopher said, "He who hath many friends hath none"? Ariana?
Aristotle.
It is Aristotle. Nice job. West, world history is your category. Towards the end of World War II, SS war criminals, too well known to escape detection for long, fled Germany. Most of them emigrated to what nation? Dante?
Argentina.
Argentina, very good. Northwest, U.S. history is your category. The high school dropout rate is a concern in today's society, but before 1855, young people were not required to go to school. In that year, what New England state passed the first compulsory school attendance laws in the United States? Arvin.
Massachusetts.
Massachusetts, very good. West, science, chemistry. What metal is found in the ores taconite, siderite, magnetite, magnetite, and hematite? Shrivitz?
Iron.
It is iron. Huskies, British government is your category. Name the longest serving British Prime Minister of the 20th century. Arvin.
David Cameron.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. West, chance to steal this British government category. Name the longest serving British Prime Minister of the 20th century. Shrevitz?
Thatcher.
It is Thatcher. West, we are staying with you. World geography is the category. Which of the following is not a dependency? We'll finish the question. Which of the following is not a dependency of Great Britain? Is it Bermuda, the Falkland Islands, Pitcairn Island, Gibraltar, or Singapore? Shrevitz?
Singapore.
Singapore is the one that is not. With that correct response, you've taken a 1-point lead as we head into halftime. Blue Valley West 12, Blue Valley Northwest 11. And this part of our program, we will go to a student representative from each team as they will give us a campus update. And it looks like, Ben, you're giving us the update for the Huskies.
So today we start off our Spirit Week for our Sweetheart Dance here at Northwest. And as you can see, all of us are wearing college shirts because today is College Day. Our Sweetheart game is this Friday night with the dance on Saturday. Our boys basketball team has had a great season so far, and last weekend we beat our rivals North. Our musical is coming up next week. We are performing the musical Aida, written by Elton John.
All right, good stuff. What's your favorite Spirit Day going to be?
I think Netflix Day will probably be our best day. That's Wednesday.
That's a solid Spirit Day right there. All right, and Hamant, you are giving us the update for the Jaguars. What's happening out in the land of Blue Valley West?
Our two-speaker debate team just performed at the state competition, and our very own Shrevitz and Daniel Berzer did very well and got third place at the competition, so we're proud of them. Our theater department is putting on All Shook Up this weekend, which will be very fun to watch. Our basketball team also did very well, and our Spanish National Honor Society is actually having their bingo competition, so if you're interested in that, you should definitely show up.
Right. Is it still bingo in Spanish?
I'm not sure.
Okay. All right. I may ask that as one of the questions, and maybe in the playoffs. We'll look forward to that. All right, as we head into the second round here on Categories, it is the lightning round, and as tradition here, we will start our lightning round with our look and listen question, in which we will display our clue for the contestants here in our studio, as well as displaying it on the screen for you playing at home. The look and listen question is worth 2 points, and just this reminder, once someone rings in, we cannot rewind the tape. We have to go from that point forward. So here we go, both teams. Here's the look and listen question. What is the subject of the following 1985 Senate hearing?
So, the choice the parent has then is to sit down and listen to every song on the album, right?
Or read the lyrics if they're on the record.
And if you want to protect that child from unnecessary exposure to inappropriate material, you sometimes need a little help.
Dante.
Censorship.
I'm sorry, we cannot accept censorship. Northwest, chance to steal. Ben.
Is it a Def Leppard album?
I'm sorry, cannot accept that. They're looking at whether or not to place the explicit lyrics label on records. So that didn't happen before 1985. So, and for those playing at home, yes, that was Dee Snider of Twisted Sister that was performed. That was in front of Al Gore right there. All right, as we continue on with our lightning round, questions are placed on the floor for either team to answer. If they respond correctly, of course, they earn a point for their team. If they don't answer correctly, the other team still gets a chance to steal. So here we go. The category is vocabulary. From the old English word for bake, it's the amount of cookies made in one baking. What's the word? Ariana?
Dozen.
I'm sorry, cannot accept dozen. Wes, chance to steal this vocabulary question from an old English word for bake. It's the amount of cookies made in one baking. Dante.
Would it be a batch?
It is a batch. Music for both teams, multiple choice. What does the meter or time signature at the beginning of a song tell you? Is it how many notes per measure? How many measures in the song? How many beats per measure? Ben.
How many beats per measure?
How many beats per measure? Very good. Entertainment, specifically film for both squads. Although she made as much as $300,000 per film, what young actress received a weekly allowance of just $4.25? Dante.
Shirley Temple.
Shirley Temple. Science terminology for both teams. Identify this thing that contains the word simple. It's a monosaccharide. Amant?
Simple sugar.
It's a simple sugar. U.S. history for both teams. Immediately following the Russian Revolution, there was a panic in the United States that communism would spread to this, that would spread to this country. Ben.
The Red Scare.
It is the Red Scare. And what was that panic called? U.S. history for both teams. Looking for a two-word phrase here. During the 17th century, most of the white laborers in Maryland and Virginia came from England as what classification? Arvin.
Indentured servants.
Indentured servants, very good. General knowledge. Pressed folds of cloth on skirts or slacks are called what? Ariana.
Pleats.
They are pleats, and we have a tie game at 15 apiece. Economics for both teams. The right or privilege to buy or sell property on designated terms is what? It's an option, an option. Music, this time instruments. Name any four of the six instruments in the woodwind family. Arvin.
Clarinet, flute, saxophone, oboe.
Very good. Bassoon and English horn would have been the other two. World geography, specifically language for both teams. What is the primary language in Mozambique, Congo, Somalia, Tanzania, Uganda, and Kenya? Shrivitz.
French.
I'm sorry, cannot accept French. Ariana.
Swahili.
Swahili is correct. U.S. geography for both teams. Which capital city with the tallest capitol building in the United States was the former home of Lyndon Johnson when he accompanied his father to the legislature? Arvin?
Austin.
It is Austin. Literature for both teams. From the works of Kipling in the Jungle Books, what is the name of the Indian child who becomes Amand?
Mowgli.
It is Mowgli. Science, physics for both teams. Name the elementary particle with no charge or mass. Ben?
A neutron.
I'm sorry, I cannot accept that. West, you have a chance to steal this physics question. Name the elementary particle with no charge or mass that travels at light speed. Neha?
Photon.
Cannot accept photon. It's neutrino. Neutrino. Language, origin for both teams. What name is given to the English language as spoken from roughly 450 to 1100 AD? Ben?
Old English?
It is Old English. That's where they got the word batch from. Literature, authors from both teams. What did Ambrose Bierce call a period of 365 disappointments? Shrivitz?
A year.
It is a year. Really, he's an optimistic guy. All right, Shakespeare for both teams. Starts off with a quote. He's in Arthur's bosom, if ever man went to Arthur's bosom. This line from Henry V concerns the death of what character who previously appeared in Henry IV? It is Falstaff, Falstaff. Presidential history. This question relates to the eerie coincidences between the lives of two great presidents, Lincoln and Kennedy. Both were shot on what day of the week? Ariana?
Wednesday.
It is not a Wednesday. West, chance to steal this presidential histories category. This question relates to the eerie coincidences between the lives of two great U.S. presidents, Lincoln and Kennedy. Both were shot... Amand?
Sunday.
Not Sunday, Friday. Friday. World history for both teams. What international group failed significantly to halt the invasion of China by Japan, the invasion of Ethiopia by Italy, and the Civil War? Ben?
League of Nations.
It was the League of Nations. General knowledge, this time about the holidays. The Canadians celebrate Remembrance Day annually. It is their name for an equivalent American holiday, which is... Ben?
Veterans Day.
Veterans Day. Geography, this time terminology. What do we call the land area that is drained by a stream or river? Arvin?
Delta.
Cannot accept delta. West, chance to steal this geography terminology question. What do we call the land area that is drained by a stream or river? Neha?
A basin.
It's not a basin, it's a watershed. A watershed. Another geography question for both teams, Middle East specifically. The name Benjamin has been variously translated as son of my right hand, favorite son, or son of the south. This last meaning appears in the Arabic form as the name of what country on the Arabian Peninsula? Alex.
Yemen.
It is Yemen. Fine arts. Music and theater is the next category. Musically speaking, the passage depicts the troubles one might get into when rushing in where prejudice dictates otherwise, or prudence dictates otherwise. Identify the central figure in this composition by Paul Dukas. It's The Sorcerer's Apprentice. Poetry for both teams. Name two of the three principal characters in Dante's Divine Comedy. Dante, Virgil, and Beatrice are the three. Military history for both teams. During the Vietnam War, Vietnamese communists established the Ho Chi Minh Trail through the remote mountains of what country to channel troops and supplies? Ben.
Cambodia.
It is not Cambodia. West, you have a chance to steal this military history question. During the Vietnam War, Vietnamese communists established the Ho Chi Minh Trail through the remote mountains of what country to channel troops and supplies from North Vietnam to South Vietnam? Armand?
Laos.
It is Laos. Great Britain, and history of Great Britain is the next category. Women mounted a military campaign to gain the right to vote in Britain in 1909. The newspapers referred to this group of women as what? Ariana?
The suffragists.
Suffragists, very good. Mythology for both teams. One side was a woman, this is mythology. One side was a woman out of whose side grew vicious dogs. On the other side was a menacing whirlpool. Name these two formidable foes of many sailors in Greek mythology. Alex?
The sirens.
Cannot accept sirens. Wes, chance to steal this mythology question. One side was a woman out of whose side grew vicious dogs. On the other was a menacing whirlpool. Name these two formidable foes of many sailors in Greek mythology. Scylla and Charybdis. Science for both teams. Posted in the mission control room of the Johnson Space Center is a digital display board with the following GMT. What does GMT stand for? Ariana.
Greenwich Mean Time.
Greenwich Mean Time. You guys open up a bit of a lead here, 24 to 18. Film is the next category. What actress played opposite of Paul Newman on Cat in a Hot Tin Roof? It was Elizabeth Taylor. Economics for both teams. Give me the full name of the economist from whom after the Keynesian school. Come on.
John Maynard Keynes.
That's correct. World history explorers for both teams. On his first voyage, Columbus' navigational instruments were so crude that he relied almost solely upon dead reckoning to steer his ships. What nocturnal body did he use? Ben.
The North Star.
The North Star. World geography for both teams. Name the eastern mouth of the Great Amazon System, actually an arm of the Atlantic Ocean. That is the Para River. And that siren does denote the end of our contest. And we have Blue Valley Northwest coming out on top with a score of 25 to Blue Valley West 19. Please join us again next time here on Categories as we will continue to bring you the best and brightest minds of high school students all throughout Johnson County.